Well, hey guys, if you're new here, I'm a board certified dermatologist, and in this video, I'm gonna be talking about at-home radio frequency devices. Do these things actually work? What do? Are they good for anti-aging? Before getting into today's video, I wanna take a moment to thank today's video sponsor, Skin Store. You know, I love shopping on Skin Store for skincare. They have a ton of fantastic brands from all different price points. Right now, they actually are giving me a discount code for you guys, so if you wanna shop on Skin Store, my code may be able to save you a little bit. But if you're wondering what I'm wearing on my lips, as a side note, it is a favorite SPF lip balm from MD Solar Science. It's a little messy because I've been using it quite a bit. The shade is red. It's their Hydrating Sheer Lip Balm SPF 30. Got it on Skin Store. You can actually get a whole set of all of the shades of their tinted lip balms. You know, this video is all about anti-aging and shelling out a ton of money for an expensive anti-aging device or treatment, but when it comes to protecting your skin from the visible signs of skin aging, come on, sunscreen is really where it's at, blocking those UV rays that directly destroy the collagen in your skin, leading to wrinkle formation, including the skin around your lips. So this has been a go-to for me for protecting the skin on my lips from those UV rays. It's really moisturizing, and it has a nice tint. It's got avocado oil in it, which is a nice emollient. It stays on really well. Now, if you watched my best sunscreens of 2021 video, definitely check that out if you missed it. But you'll recall that a favorite tinted mineral sunscreen from 2021 was the Epion's Daily Shield Tinted SPF 50. This is a tinted all mineral sunscreen. It's water resistant. It has a nice shade that is suitable for medium skin tones such as myself. It stays in place really well, it doesn't have any fragrance, and it gives the skin a really nice, healthy, radiant glow. Now, I mentioned the MD Solar Science tinted lip balms, but these, you guys know, are also favorites from MD Solar Science. They're Mineral Cream SPF 50. This is an all mineral sunscreen. It's very moisturizing, cruelty free and vegan. And then this is their tinted mineral sunscreen SPF 30. I would say the tint on this is actually very similar to the tint on the Epion's. Yeah, I wanted to give those sunscreens a quick shout out because they're some of my favorites. You can get them on Skin Store. And again, when it comes to warding off the visible signs of skin aging, if you are not protecting your skin from the sun, you are, you know, you're going down the wrong path. And of course, it can be very challenging to find a sunscreen that you like, that you're willing to wear on a daily basis. So definitely check out Skin Store. And these are some of my favorite sunscreens. Radio frequency is a low energy form of radiation, and the way it works to improve wrinkles, fine lines, and skin sagging is basically heating the deeper layers of the skin to trigger fibroblasts. Those are cells in the deeper layers of the skin that make collagen, and it triggers them to start making collagen again, leading to a skin firming and skin smoothing effect, ultimately improving sagging. It can improve the look of cellulite as well. You may have heard of the popular radio frequency treatment Thermage. Not only does radio frequency help smooth out wrinkles and have a skin firming and skin tightening effect, it's also helpful for improving the look of sun damage. It's a body contouring treatment, so it may be used elsewhere on the body for a firming and tightening effect. It's used on the face a fair amount, not only for, you know, improving wrinkles, sagging, etc., but it's been shown actually to have a slimming effect and actually trigger fat loss. So around the jowl area, using radio frequency treatments can kind of help in facial contouring, and there's really not much pain, and it's a desirable procedure because there's no downtime. You don't really have to prepare much for it. You know, some treatments like lasers, you've got to stop certain skincare products in advance. You kind of have to book out some time after the procedure where you kind of lay low to recover. This is in and out. It takes maybe about 45 minutes to an hour. It's really a satisfying procedure to have done for many people because you almost immediately appreciate about a 10% improvement, and that, you know, people like instant gratification. So I think that is another reason why this procedure has gained so much attention and popularity, the limited downtime and that kind of, you know, very instant gratification. But that improvement doesn't just stop there. You continue to get improvement roughly 3 to 6 months after the treatment. So it's not all about instant gratification. You continue to have ongoing improvement, and people also like that too. Not only do they get that quick dopamine hit, they also have you know, more improvement with time. So they feel as though they get their money's worth, so to speak. And in terms of improvement, not everybody is happy with their results, as with any cosmetic treatment. I highly suggest, you know, going to a board certified dermatologist or plastic surgeon who actually does this and, you know, really sitting down with them, telling them what it is that you are hoping to achieve, what your concerns are. They will go over and set your expectations. This may not even be something that you are even interested in. The at-home devices, I'm going to cover, you know, what the research says as far as their efficacy, but they are not inexpensive. So I do think it is important to have realistic expectations. So why would you even want to bother to do this at home when you have professionals out there who do this for a living? You could just go to their office and have these procedures done. Well, they're not inexpensive. That's probably why you clicked on this video. You don't want to shell out that kind of coin, or maybe you don't have that in your budget, or maybe you saw good results doing this procedure and you want to see if you can do it in a more cost-effective way as maintenance at home. Reasonable thing to query on the interwebs. Roughly the procedure, depending on the area that you're going to have treated, where you live, the cost is going to vary, anywhere from $1,000 to $4,000. But do the at-home radio frequency devices even work? Research which suggests that they can work and are a safe option for people looking for an at-home treatment. You know, with the pandemic, as I like to call it, there has been such an uptick in telemedicine. And with that, you are seeing more and more at-home devices. Consumers are really interested in this. It's not going anywhere. You're going to probably continue to see even more devices and at-home, you know, dermatologic telehealth platforms, etc. I mean, so this is really an avenue where you're going to see more and more and more. The research that we have does suggest that the at-home radio frequency devices are effective and are safe. Are they going to be as effective as the stuff that you would get in office? Probably not, honestly, but they can help. And so I think they are an option, a good option, a reasonable option for people out there who probably have already had the in-office procedures and are looking for maybe something to do as maintenance, or for just a little subtle skin firming, skin tightening. As far as research, you know, there's a randomized controlled trial that shows decent improvement in forehead wrinkles with an at-home radio frequency device. There's another similar study that's not randomized that shows improvement in skin elasticity and in skin wrinkling. Unfortunately, you know, these studies, you got to take them with a grain of salt because most of them are industry funded by the maker of the device. And, you know, some of them are very small. Very few of them out there are randomized controlled trials. So what the research we have to date suggests is that they can be effective for having a skin firming effect, and they are safe to do at home. So if you've got one or you're interested in one, yes, they do appear to be safe. Really no adverse effects with those. Some temporary redness, swelling. Recently, there was a systematic review of the literature of at-home devices, and they broke it down based on types of device. And in that study, they actually looked at the literature on at-home radio frequency devices. The studies I'm mentioning here, which I will link down below in the description box as references, they were covered in this paper, and the paper concluded that overall, the quality of evidence to support doing at-home radio frequency treatments is level B. It's not as though we have the most robust body of literature on these at-home devices. And again, the limitations are, you know, industry sponsored. Some of them are just very small, but as it stands, they do appear to be safe and effective. So which one is the best? That's probably what you want to know. Like, okay, so you're saying that they might work. Which one should I get? I wish I could tell you which one was the best. You're just not going to find a study that compares different ones on the market in a really objective fashion. You're pretty much going to get an anecdote. When it comes to any device on the market that you're going to buy and use at home, I always suggest getting one that is FDA cleared. To be clear, FDA cleared does not mean FDA approved. And so I suggest choosing one that is FDA cleared. It's kind of a little bit more vetted than, you know, some random one that's not FDA cleared. And there are several on the market, and several of these devices have appeared in these studies. The Tripolar is one that appears in a fair number of studies that you can find on PubMed. Again, they're pretty much all gonna be sponsored by this Tripolar group, but Tripolar is one that, you know, has shown up in the literature, as is another one called Niwa, and then one called Silk M. So, you know, those are some devices. They're not inexpensive. They're gonna run you, you know, anywhere from $400 to maybe upwards of $800. They add different bells and whistles to them, as with any device. For example, the Tripolar, they've got a few models, and they have one model that they claim has this like algorithm in it that kind of detects the heat in your skin for more precise, because really radio, the way radio frequency works is through heating up those deeper layers of the skin to generate that process of collagen rebuilding, collagen synthesis. But they claim that one of their devices has like this algorithm that kind of detects heat in different areas for more precise delivery of the radio frequency to different areas. But whether or not that makes that device any better than any other on the market, you know, you're kind of at the mercy of the manufacturer's claims in that case. But regardless, I have never personally used any of these devices. I think these are going to be most helpful maybe in areas where you have a little bit of subtle early sagging related to age-related loss of collagen in the deeper layers of the skin. I think that's where you're likely to see the best results with this. Now, in the studies, they use these treatments. You know, that's another thing. How often do you need to use them to get the best results? I would, of course, follow the manufacturer's instructions for their particular device. They really just looked at one treatment, and then immediately after that one treatment. And then another study was done on 45 patients. The patients did 5 treatments for 4 weeks, and then they did a maintenance treatment 2 times a week for 7 weeks. And that study showed, you know, some improvement in elasticity. The big picture thing here, and what the radio frequency is targeting, is going to be, you know, collagen synthesis. But there's also, as part of the, you know, aging of the face, we have bone loss and we have redistribution of fatty tissue, and that, you know, can contribute to a lot of sagging and things. So for profound sagging jowls, I don't think you are going to get much in the way of tightening from a device like these. If you want to go a more natural route for improving collagen or protecting your collagen, obviously protecting your skin from the sun, that's where it's at, honestly. But your lifestyle factors, getting good quality sleep, eating a healthy diet that isn't laden with processed sugary junk that contributes to advanced glycation end products that glom onto your collagen and, you know, advance the signs of skin aging, as well as poor health. Don't smoke. You are doing those things, and you know, you want to shell out close to $800 for an at-home radio frequency device, I would say, you know, I don't, your priorities are off. But, you know, if you are really motivated, you do sunscreen, you do sun protection, sun protective clothing, you know, are doing everything, you're just really motivated, then yeah, I mean, you may see a skin firming effect with this. All right, you guys, that is everything about at-home radio frequency. I will list my references down below in the description box, but comment below if you have purchased any of these devices that I mentioned. What has been your experience with them? Were you satisfied? Let us know in the comments. And also, one thing I have to add is, if you are contemplating getting one of these devices, really do some serious self-reflection on if you have the time and motivation to stick with it. Because it's not gonna tighten your skin sitting in the drawer, and you would have wasted a lot of money. So really think about that before making the decision to buy any device, seriously. If you don't have the time, and you're just not one of those people who is motivated to do these things, then don't buy it. Honestly, it won't tighten your skin in a drawer. Anyways, thank you so much to Skin Store for sponsoring today's video. If you guys are in the market for sunscreen or any type of skincare product, definitely check out Skin Store. Use my code to save yourself a little bit of extra. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends. And as always, don't forget, sunscreen and subscribe. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye.